Explorer wants to know why Dora wants to be an explorer.
Hold on, let me think about this one. I think because she just loves to help people. Like, through her show, she helps her friends. She even helps strangers. Like, she'll see a little animal on the floor, and she'll just ask them if they need any help, you know? And I guess she just loves to learn new things and, you know, teach them to her friends, too, so that, you know, she can talk to them about it. And she just loves exploring. It's like her own little world, you know?
Only in Washington would we get this question. Is Dora given fair and equitable pay for her work?
I don't know if I can answer that question, but you know, I don't know, like, to me, I don't, doing Dora is just like such a great thing, you know. Teaching kids, you know, about and learning Spanish. I mean, a lot of people come up to me that saying, "Oh, my daughter is just talking Spanish, and I don't know what she's saying." Like, you know, that, like, their first words either Dora or gracias or something, and you know, it's just a great feeling. But the money, I don't know. My mom takes care of that stuff. I really don't know.
How did Dora's voice came to be?
I've heard a lot of stories from all the creators and stuff, but at first it was supposed to start like as a bunny and like, you know, two little bunnies and like all that. But then Brown Johnson, one of the executive producers of Nickelodeon, she went to this meeting and they were talking about Hispanics and like the Hispanic community and how Nick Jr. needs to be involved in that. So then she decided to make it a Latina girl, and like they just started going with ideas. They started researching, you know, the Latin America, and they just put the show together, and it's a